Hello, my friends. Welcome to Forex VKS. Today is 13th of October. Today is Wednesday. Let's check in. Let's check out the introduction before we dive into the news and the chart.
Disclaimer, be advised that I am not a professional financial consultant or advisor. I am sharing this information for education purpose only. Any opinions, news, research, analysis, prices, or other information contained on this video is my own opinion and does not constitute investment advice. I will not accept liability for any loss or damage, including without limitation to any loss of profit, money, asset or any valuables which may arise directly or indirectly from use of information in this video.
Okay, let's check out the news first. So yesterday we got this, yesterday evening, right, we got this zero economy sentiment from German, which is dropped quite a lot. Okay, dropped quite a lot. Actually, they expect a 27.9 and a 23.7, right? A drop, okay? A drop of the previous result, right? But the result came in even worse. Okay, so this is very bad for the euro. Okay, so euro should remain weak. Okay, continuing this week. Okay, we don't see anything that is gonna push the euro up, but US, okay, US yesterday the jobs opening data also not doing well. That's why you don't see a lot of gain on the euro USD yesterday, because the jobs, okay, they expect a drop from the previous number, but it actually dropped even worse. Okay, so there is a conflicting data. Okay, so euro is getting weak, US is getting weak, so we are not getting any momentum in this pair, right? In this pair, so a lot of ups and downs. So But, okay, as I said, Monday and Tuesday, you won't see a lot of volatility due to the, okay, this limited data coming out from the news. But volatility should pick up on Wednesday and Thursday, because Wednesday we get this, okay, US CPI number coming in, which is important. Okay, so they expect a CPI number to remain and the core CPI to go up. Okay, so if this result came up better than expected, right? Okay, it will certainly boost the USD. Okay, so the USD could make a gain towards the euro tonight. Okay, tonight, 8:30 p.m. We are in the Asia time, we are in the Singapore time. So this could be, okay, a further gain for USD or a further drop. Okay, if this number come out below expectation, so this could be a drop for the USD. So tomorrow you have to be careful. Okay, tomorrow we got FOMC meeting coming in and FOMC member speaking, so this one be careful. And we also got this Australia data coming in, employment rate. Okay, so they expect a improvement in unemployment rate. So we also have PPI number from US and employment claim. Okay, so this one tomorrow expect a bigger movement on USD and starting from tonight, okay, bigger movement on USD and AUD. And on Friday, okay, we get this core retail sales. Okay, core retail sales. Okay, so these are UOM sentiment, US. So a lot of US data coming out, so expect volatility for USD starting from tonight, okay, tomorrow and Friday. Check out the chart. DXY. So DXY is yo-yo, okay, yo-yoing. Okay, around this area, a resistant one area, the price actually broke through. Okay, the price broke through, but we can't make up. Actually, this is 1-2-3 break. This is a good opportunity to make a 1-2-3. Okay, 1-2-3 continuation, right? Okay, so it broke the high over here. Okay, but we could not execute this trade because the resistance line is way too near. Okay, it's way too near. So don't expect every trade, every setup is a trade. Okay, every setup, don't expect that, because market got a lot of things that can catch us. Even we see a beautiful trade, but we can't take it because it is too near to the resistance. So we only trade the best of the best trade. Okay, because we are doing trading the day candle, right? We don't trade often, but we only select the best trade. Okay, if you're a day trader, you are 5 minute, 15 minute trader. Okay, you can. A lot of these are day trader. They do trade a lot. Okay, but some of the trade is not okay. Not the best setup that they sometimes they have to go in, because they have their target every day. But I'm not saying they cannot make money. Okay, if you are good, okay, the probability of winning is still okay. In long term, right, you are still going to make money even though you lose a lot during if you are doing a day trader, because at the end of the day, if you use a good risk to reward ratio, right, even a not very high winning percentage of 40%, okay, you should be okay making good money, good income. Okay, similar Euro USD broke through our 1, 2, 3. Okay, we are trading this, right? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 break, right? So we broken our the bottom over here. So we took a sell trade, but the price did not continue, come back down, because there's not much data to push the market these 2 days. But expect volatility starting tonight. So tonight it could be starting to go down, okay, to our target, or it might come back to reach our to hit our stop loss. Okay, but we are not changing this trade. Remember, we don't want to change simply go and change the trade without a very big reason. Okay, because it will adjust, it will affect our long-term performance. So USD JPY, right? As I said, USD JPY, you shall not pass over here. So I'm not keen to trade this. Okay, because we got all this top over here. So this area, right, is you shall not pass. So we have to be careful. I'm not trading. Although we can see, right, the USD against the yen is extremely weak this week. Okay, and this week you can see, you can feel it. Okay, you can see the 1, 2, 3 continuation. I did not take this trade. Actually, I said this trade you can take if you want to take higher risk. I didn't take, but this is a probable trade. As a previous video, Monday video, I talked about this, right? I said it's probable to take. To take this trade. If you took it, okay, congratulations. You don't take it, never mind. Set up, okay, every day we got set up coming in. Okay, so this is you shall not pass. So I'm not keen, okay? You shall not pass, right? So this area, I'm not keen trading, buying into this area, okay? This one, wait and see, okay? So we already got one trade over here. So don't worry, we already got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 set up opportunity, right? In 1 week, it's more than enough, okay? We don't need to go for every trade in the market. AUD USD slowly going down to R2. Okay, this one there is a possible sell opportunity here at R2. Okay, so watch R2. USD CAD. Okay, so USD CAD, we are not seeing a lot here. We are not seeing a lot. USD CAD, even with a very strong oil, is not gaining a lot on USD. This means that USD is not as weak that as expected, okay, even though with yesterday the poor jobs number, right? So it is not as weak as expected. Okay, if USD is weak, right, as the CAD is so strong, right, the oil price now is over 80 per barrel, right, it should be rocketing down. Okay, but it's not. Okay, so from here, right, we can see the sentiment that USD aren't that weak, okay. So now the price is yo-yoing between R1 and S1. Okay, now this is interesting right here. Okay, let me put the line properly. Okay. So most likely, how I would trade this, I will wait for a well-developed pin bar over here. Retracement toward resistance one, a well-developed pin bar over here, yes. Okay, there's a sell opportunity here. Now there's no man's land, okay? All the price breakthrough, support one, retest, resumption, okay, I will go for a trade. So this one, we're still waiting and see if it's possible there's a trade here. Pound USD haven't breakthrough the support line over here that we put up yesterday, okay? We are looking for a 1, 2, 3 break. So after so many candles, right, I'm not interested to trade the 1, 2, 3 break anymore. Okay, I'm not interested to trade the 1, 2, 3 break anymore. Let me see how this works out. So there is a possible of a 1-2-3 trade here, okay, a break of the bottom here, but as the sideways price action, okay, as the sideways price action remain longer, right, okay, the less interest I want to trade, okay, because there will be a lot of false break coming in. So this one, let me see how many candles here now. I reconsolidate. Too many candles. Okay, too many candles. I will not be taking out the break over here. No. Okay, I will not. So what I will do is I want to wait for a break, retest, resumption. Okay, only I will take the trade. Let me mark the area, the breakout area again. 135.688. Okay, so towards the target 134.210. Okay, but I will not take the break. I will take the retest. Okay, because this one is too many candle consolidation, too many candle. You can see this is a railroad track. Again, you can see, right, what is this? Okay, you can see this. This is a railroad track. Okay, with a lot of pin bar. New Zealand dollar USD, New Zealand dollar USD, we are still in this trade. It's not going anywhere. Okay, it is just not going anywhere. New Zealand dollar tried to go up, but you see so many tail here. Okay, so the USD is still very strong. A lot of support, getting a lot of support, a lot of tail. Okay, so we are still holding this trade. We are trading the 1-2-3, okay, 1-2-3 reversal over here, the 1-2-3 reversal. Our target is at support 2, so the price actually stopped a little bit below support 2. Okay. But purely, if you talk about the 1-2-3 reversal target, reversal pattern, right, it already hit the target. Okay, it has already hit the target because the target should be here, the same length, okay, from the neckline, okay, from the neckline of this trade. Okay, so the price would have already hit the target over here. Okay, here to here. Okay. Target is similar length, right? So it's similar length. You see this one similar length. Actually, it already hit the target on the 4-hour basis. On the 1 hour, so we kind of hope it go down a little bit more, but it did not. But we are still holding this trade. Okay, anything still can happen. If we get a good PPI number tonight, okay, this one will continue to go down. Similar go. So nothing too much happening these few days. Okay, go. You can see it's a railroad track over here. So we are not trading this, okay, we are not trading this. Also, we are not trading this. Okay, there's another already one breakout, false break over here. So it can be many false break coming in, okay. So it can be false break here, no. So we are not trading this. What I want to trade is, okay, a clean breakout, a clean break, retest, resumption only I will take. Okay, for a sell trade. You're still selling this as long as it's below our bias line, R2, 1800. Okay, so SPI is nearing a possible trade. It's nearing to a possible trade. We got a pin bar here yesterday. We are still selling this as long as it's below 7410, below R2. We are still selling this, but the price is more and more congestion, too much congestion for me, for my liking to trade. Okay. A lot of congestion over here, a lot of congestion, too much congestion. We got a big railroad track here, we got a small railroad track here. So you see, we got a big railroad track here, right? Okay, big railroad track here, ignore this. Okay, then you see there is a railroad track. And now we are getting another small railroad track here, which is not ideal to trade. Okay, not ideal to trade. Not like this one. Do you want to trade this? I don't think so, right? A railroad track, right? Railroad track means bear and the bull are almost equal, right? So if you buy into a railroad track, okay, you most likely will get stopped out. If you sell into a railroad track, you most likely will get stopped out. You see, okay, you see a big bearish candle, right? So when you want to sell over here, right? So you get stopped out, okay? You see another big bearish candle, right? You want to sell here, right? Okay, even back up here, stop out. You see a big bullish candle over here, right? You want to buy, right? You see the price went down to here, you get stopped out. Okay, so we are not trading this. Okay, we are not trading this. Okay, I'm not keen in this. We already got 1, 2, 3, 4 set up. So don't be too aggressive to trade every trade, because we already got. If you don't have any setup, maybe you say, oh, I want to be aggressive. Look for the setup that is not so good. Okay, not so high probability, right? But we already got so many setup here. So don't rush. Okay, so this is another railroad track. I also not keen to trade this, right? Okay. In a trending market, right? You can't draw a railroad track, right? How do you draw a railroad track? Okay, in the trading market, in a trending market, right? You see, you can't draw a railroad track, right? Let me see. Let me see whether I can get a trending market, right? Okay, you see when the market is trending, right? This one, you see, you can't find a railroad track over here. Okay, so when it start to railroad track, you have to slow down, okay, and wait for the breakout, right? After breakout, you see the price goes. You can't draw any railroad track here, right? Only when the price starting to go sideways, only you can draw a railroad track, right? Railroad track. Okay, when the price starting to move, you can't draw a railroad track. Okay, so this is why that we will ignore the railroad track, or you can call it sideways price action. I like to call things that a bit more excitement, okay, with a bit more excitement. So I remember what that I mentioned last time. Like I mentioned, you shall not pass, right? So when I already mentioned you shall not pass, I highlight the area, then I always remember this area that is danger, okay, you cannot go through, that the price struggle to go through, right? Okay, so we have another trade in our favor here. Remember, we are trading this, right? Tweezer top, okay, the break of the tweezer top. There's a possible sell trade towards support one. Now the price is going down. Okay, so this one already, okay, in our favor. Euro USD is slightly in our favor. We got this another, and then NZD USD now is a bit against our trade. So this is in our favor. Okay, so this is continue to hold it towards support one. So the Dow Jones. Okay, Dow Jones, we did not get a very good price action over here. Okay, we did not get a good price action over here. Otherwise, we could have a sell opportunity here. If we print out a good pin bar over here, yes. Okay, but it print out a good bearish engulfing. Yes, this is a trade, but it's too near to our target, so we are not taking this. Okay, and this is, if you look at the long term, this is still a railroad track, right? So you look at the weekly, right? You look at the weekly, okay? A railroad track, right? So we don't want to trade this, okay? We don't want to trade this. If you trade this, right, most likely you get you get hurt. S&P. Okay, S&P, there's a possible sell trade after the price broke here, but I didn't manage to catch it. Somehow I miss it. I'm not sure why. I'm not sure how I miss it, but I miss it. Okay, so if you call it, right, okay, this is a consolidation. A price broke through. You see the pin bar over here, right? Okay, but this time I'm not very strong. We get another pin bar. Oh, yeah, yesterday we talked about this. I almost forgot. Okay, retest and resumption. Okay, so it already happened. So there is a trade over here. Okay, if I miss it, but if you didn't miss it, yesterday I was quite busy actually, right? If you didn't miss it, you could have called it, okay? Retest and resumption. So the price, you look at the 1 hour, it went back to retest. Okay, so the price came from here, right? It came back to here, right? Okay, so then it came back to here and rebound. Now the price is coming down, right? Okay. So there is a retest. Also, there is a 1, 2, 3 continuation. Once the price broke through the 4 hour here, the 4 hour, right, broke through the bottom here, you can see it's a 1, 2, 3 continuation, right? Okay, so there's another trade, SBS, possible trade here. Okay, towards our support one. Okay, from R1 4377 towards 4307. Look at Bitcoin. So Bitcoin is is continue rocket up. Okay, Bitcoin is very very strong. Bitcoin has outpaced all the other. Normally normally when Bitcoin start to move, right, the altcoin will outpace the Bitcoin, right? But this time it's different. Bitcoin outpaced everybody. So Bitcoin is continue rocket up, go go go. Then Ethereum is still sleeping. Okay, still is a sleeping dragon, waiting to still haven't awake. Let me see if I can find a sleeping dragon or not. Give me a second. Yeah, I got it. This is Ethereum, a sleeping dragon. Okay, so Litecoin similar, still sleeping, XRP still sleeping. Okay, so never mind. As long as Bitcoin is leading the way, it shouldn't be a problem. The altcoin should catch up soon. Okay, we don't want we rather see a rocketing Bitcoin and a sleeping altcoin, right? Sleeping altcoin rather than a moving up altcoin and a super drop a dropping Bitcoin. We don't want to see that because Bitcoin is the leading cryptocurrency. And sometimes we can say it's a leading indicator in the crypto world. Okay, when the Bitcoin start to move, most of the altcoin will start to move. So this could be a manipulation. Okay, they push up the Bitcoin, so a lot of investor will see, hey, what happened to my altcoin? Altcoin is not moving. So they say, okay, I will sell all my altcoin to chase the Bitcoin, which Bitcoin already very high. Okay, so they already lose their holding on cheap altcoin, right? And they go and buy the high Bitcoin. Okay, this is sometimes it's not to your advantage because when the altcoin move, right, okay, in the manner of the Bitcoin, right, means start to move a big, right? So you already lost the gain. Okay, you already lost the gain that when the altcoin move, you already lost the gain of this the next spike. Okay, where Bitcoin, right, already spike. Okay, Bitcoin already spike means you go in, you're already buying expensive. Okay, where else Ethereum, Litecoin, you're still holding it cheap. But if you sell it out and you buy the Bitcoin, means you're selling the whole your holding of cheap coins, right, to buy expensive coin. Okay, so this sometimes is what the market wants you to do. Okay, so they push the Bitcoin up. You think, oh no, my altcoin are not moving. I want to sell my altcoin and buy Bitcoin. Where you already lost the gain, right? When you go into Bitcoin, right, you already miss out this gain. Okay, where if you keep the altcoin, right, if the altcoin or the other altcoin went up, you should be able to enjoy this gain. But you already sold it and buy Bitcoin, which already passed. Okay, the gain already passed this stage, right, already passed. So you're buying at expensive, you're selling your cheap one. So think about it. I'm not saying that this must be the right scenario. It guarantee it will happen. Maybe altcoin will never go up, only Bitcoin go up. I don't know. Okay, but if you do sell the altcoin to buy Bitcoin now, means you are selling your cheap holding and buying the expensive Bitcoin now. Not to say expensive, but higher price Bitcoin now. Okay, so that's it for today. Don't forget to do one thing for me, which is I'm sorry, it's not one thing, three things for me: subscribe, like, and share this with your friend. Okay, share it with your mates that do trading. Share this with your cousin that does trading. Share this with your office colleague that does that likes to trade the currency. Share this with your Telegram Gram group. Share this in your Twitter. Share this in your Facebook, whichever. Okay, we want to pump up our energy here at Forex with KS, so everyone can make money. I'm sorry, I just burped just now after my breakfast. And hopefully, okay, everyone also get educated together with Forex with KS. Okay, thank you for watching. Stay safe from coronavirus. And see you again tomorrow, 11 o'clock, 11 a.m. Singapore time. Bye bye.